Jacqueline McGlade, who is from the European Environment Agency, thanks very much for speaking to us this morning. Now, you've just sat in on the first session, the CAP in the spotlight. What did you make of the speakers and the views that were aired?
I think what the Commissioner was talking about was a very ambitious change to the CAP at one level, but it was almost sounding like business as usual when it got into the debate, with the very polarised views of trade, leave us as we are, we're over-regulated, and then perhaps a sort of clarion call from the side from Lester Brown talking about the real challenges. And I think what was fascinating was that there wasn't, for me, enough movement between the three parts to generate what I think is a succinct solution and where the CAP should really be.
Although we have to say that forums like this are at least a start to perhaps move away from those areas of polarity.
Well, one element I think that was very striking for me was this concordance around the idea that already farmers in a way have taken on into the mainstream the environment, that they really are seeing themselves not only as producers of food but also protectors of the environment. Now, I would have to say, coming from the Environment Agency, that in our State of Environment report that probably isn't the case, and that we still see that agriculture is one of the major pressures on the territory of Europe, and in many cases a very detrimental provider of, essentially negative impacts on the environment.
Farmers will say that the greening and the contribution that they're making to that, that really means that they don't really get much back for it, and in fact that they get caught up in European bureaucracy, and it's a disincentive.
I think the challenge we have is that the CAP is a very bureaucratic machinery, and it is orientated much more towards compliance than it is to outcomes. And perhaps that would be the revolution that I would be looking for, is that farmers would be judged on their outcomes. And then you would actually see whether good management practices on the land itself could adjust to the prices, could adjust to ecosystem change and climate change. But it's a big question. And ultimately, I think the CAP reform cannot be held accountable for the great challenges that surround Europe. We know that Europe depends heavily on the rest of the world for materials, resources, and for food. And therefore, I think there's got to be a realistic sense of what the CAP itself can do and what the rest of the European legislature, strategies, and thinking actually needs to also accommodate.
I think it's a very good, valid point, you know, that really the CAP can't be all things to all people. And yet, as you say, you heard views aired already, which was very much business as usual. So in terms of next steps, what do you see?
I would love to see the CAP focus on the professionalisation of agriculture, to make it, in a sense, part of a career structure, an industry that is using resources efficiently, that can, in some senses, accommodate the mismatch between what we can afford to pay in the shops and what we need to secure food for the whole of the population. And really focus on R&D, research, development and education, so that the new and next generation of farmers actually have the very best tools to confront what will inevitably be a very difficult situation. And then put demands on other policy arenas and other players to accommodate just what agriculture is able to provide.
The EA has a strong message about regulators, business, citizens working together. So, I guess days like today, when everyone can air their views, are important.
I think what's fantastic is that as this event gets bigger and bigger and we see different groups coming in, still there's a real sense of wanting to solve the problem. And I think that's genuinely what this kind of stakeholder process demonstrates, is not one of benign neglect, one where people are passionate and actually want to get involved and find what the answers will be.
And you're appearing as a panellist a little later on this morning in the session on sustainability and environmental security in farming.
There, I think the issue is about informing farmers more about the challenges in the long term so that they're not caught out, and at the same time informing the legislature about the unintended consequences of some of their decisions. Because one of the real critical points will be that as more and more agendas come together, inadvertently, we could cause damage to food security, whilst at the same time keeping a very good eye on some other territorial imperative like rural development. So I think that is the challenge that I would like to talk about in my panel discussion.
I hope it goes well. Good luck with it. Jacqueline McGlade, thanks very much for speaking to us.
Thank you.